Hello everyone. This video is in continuation to our videos on biomolecules. We are today going to start up with our last topic, a very, very important, that is enzymes. I'll make maybe 2 to 3 videos for enzymes because it's a very elaborative and a long topic. In this video, we'll talk about enzymes, how they were discovered. We'll talk about how do they affect the rate of a reaction. We'll talk about a graph of activation energy and how is it framed and what does it explain, the whole explanation of the graph, which is very, very important for any type of exam, even the NEET exam also. So please watch the video till the end. In the end, you will get all the important pointers on the board which you can use for your notes. So we'll start without wasting time. The first thing which we'll talk about, the discovery of the enzymes, we'll start with it. Now, enzymes, they were accidentally, first of all, everything was accidentally discovered. So here also, accidentally, Louis Pasteur, he found that there was some, you know, something in the reaction which was enhancing, which was increasing the rate of the reaction. He termed them as ferments, because he was talking about yeast here where fermentation was taking place. So he gave the term ferments to these chemicals or whatsoever he thought it was. Then further study was when carried out by Edward Buchner. Buchner, he isolated, he also studied yeast and isolated enzymes from yeast, from a reaction. He separated it out from the reaction. Fine. So he isolated, but the term enzyme was still not known. So no term was given. He just isolated these ferments, if you say, from the yeast. And then Kuhne gave the term enzyme. So it is the involvement of 3 scientists who at their level worked on enzymes. First one called them ferments, second one isolated them, and the third was Kuhne, who gave the term enzyme, who used the term enzyme, which means in yeast. Enzyme in yeast, because it was isolated from yeast. Now, this was the basic, you know, history of enzymes. We'll now start with the definition first. What are enzymes? Enzymes alter the rate of any reaction. Now, alter term is used. Abhi, thoda time back, it was said that it increases the rate of or enhances the rate of reaction. But that statement has been disproved, because it was found that in some reactions it also decreases the rate of reaction. So the term alter is being used now, that it alters the rate of reaction. It can either increase the reaction or decrease the reaction. Increasing or decreasing, both will take place by the addition of enzymes. So what are enzymes? They alter the rate of any reaction. Now, we will take one example to show that how much change or what kind of a change it takes place. For that, we will take up a reaction. For example, suppose carbon dioxide, it reacts with water, is reacting with water to form H2CO3 carbonic acid. Fine. So this reaction is taking place. Now, in this reaction, there is no enzyme used. And what do we observe? That there are only 200 molecules. 200 molecules per hour produced in this reaction of this product. Now, what do? The reaction remains the same, but we are using an enzyme now here, and the enzyme is carbonic anhydrase enzyme anhydrase enzyme, and now the product which we get is the same, but what is the change? Now we are getting 6 lakh molecules per hour. 6 lakh. The change is from 200 to 6 lakhs per hour. So this is how the enzymes, they enhance, they increase the number of products formed. Enzymes will increase the number of products formed. Now we will talk about how do they do it. How is it done? What is the way it is done? So we'll write here how. The question is how this alteration or this product change is done. Listen very, very, very carefully. Now herein, suppose a reaction is taking place. We'll just make a hypothetical diagram kind of a thing. Suppose a reaction is taking place, and in that reaction, we have these substrate molecules. Here, I just want to add in one pointer. I'll start writing the pointers there for your reference. So the first pointer is all substrates have a potential energy in them to carry out reaction. That means if I'm saying that these substrate molecules are there, they will possess a potential energy jo inke andar hai already, so that they carry on a reaction. Suppose that potential energy is maybe 1, 3, 2, 5, 7, 8, 11, 12. Fine. Now the reaction is going to take place. In order to carry on a reaction, there always is, I'll write here, in order to carry out a reaction, there is an activation energy of reaction which needs to be possessed by molecules, or which is needed for the reaction to take place. So suppose in this reaction, maybe the activation energy is 5. This is the activation energy. Now what will happen? The molecules which have 5 activation energy and more than that will participate in the reaction and will form the product. That means these molecules are going to form the product because they have 7, 8, 5, 11 and 12, which is 5 or more than 5 activation energy. So these are going to form the product. And suppose maybe the product which is formed is maybe 10 molecules. By using these. Okay, this is a normal state. We have not used any enzyme here. Now what do we do? We will now add enzyme here. An enzyme is added. And what will that enzyme do? Enzyme is going to decrease activation energy. That means suppose now the activation energy becomes 1. Enzyme has decreased that activation energy from 5 to 1. So now what happens? All the molecules with activation energy 1 and more will participate. So with the enzyme, all these molecules will participate in the reaction and they will maybe now form 50 molecules. This is what we get when enzyme is added. So I just want to add in something here, a pointer here, that enzyme decreases the activation energy
so that more substrates react to form product. So this is what the enzyme is doing to enhance the number of or increase the number of products. Fine. So it is decreasing. It is decreasing the activation energy. So this is how a change will take place when the enzyme will be added. Now a very, very important portion which is related to this only, that's why I'm doing it here. That is a graph which is plotted. Many a times this graph is there in the paper and you are asked to explain the graph or you are asked to write a few answers related to the graph. Now suppose we make a graph. On one axis the potential energy is marked and on the other axis the time. Maybe potential energy and time. Now I have already told you what is potential energy, the energy which is already possessed by the substrate molecules to carry on a reaction. So when we plot this graph, in the absence of enzyme, the graph goes like this. This is in the absence of enzyme, and this is a transition state. Now this is the state where the substrate is going to bind with the enzyme at this point. Fine. This is the substrate. This is, but we don't have an enzyme here, so it quickly falls off. So this is the normal state. So I'll write here I'll just write here. This is without enzyme. So in this without enzyme wala, you will see that the activation energy is quite very high. This is activation energy. Fine. Now we will plot a graph when enzyme is used. So when the enzyme is used, this activation energy is reduced. So this is reduced activation energy with presence of enzyme. So this is what this graph is depicting. When you plot a graph of any reaction, fine, so what will happen, the activation energy is too very high, but as and when enzyme is added, the activation energy lowers down. This is what is depicted by this graph, that how the lowering of activation energy will lead to more formation of more amount of products, because now more substrates are being used up to form the products in the reaction. Fine. So this is, you know, the full explanation how the enzymes are going to enhance the rate of the reaction. So the pointers you need to remember are that the enzyme, or I'll write one more pointer here. I have written that it decreases the activation energy. Add one more pointer here, that enzymes, they enable the substrates with low potential energy to participate in reaction. They enable them to participate in the reaction so that more products are formed. So we have talked about the history of the enzymes. We have discussed what does an enzyme do actually, how does it do, and these all pointers, very, very, these are the most important pointers from this portion. And I've explained you what does this graph depict. Fine. In our next video, we'll talk about the mechanism, how the enzymes, they work. We'll talk about lock and key hypothesis and induced fit. So keep watching, liking, sharing, subscribing. Thank you.